Okay, so continuing on, we've looked at what the robot is doing in this main run loop. But you'll notice, for example, the robot shoots. When we were going through that example, if we look at this battle, our robot will shoot. So how is it knowing how to do that? Well, you'll notice that there's some methods down below our main run method, like this onScanned robot method. And these work a little bit differently. These are events that are generated. So we sit there and wait for something to happen. And when that something happens, then the event is triggered. And so in this case, we've got an onScanned robot event, which is saying we scanned a robot. So when we scan a robot, it says fire with the power of one. If I were, instead of doing a fire, to say turn right 720 degrees, then if I save this and compile it, and then go back to the battle and restart it, then you'll see my robot. As soon as it scans a robot, it does a 720 degree turn, and it keeps doing it because it keeps scanning them as it turns. Because you can't see it, but let me options and go to preferences, and then in the view options you can view the scan arcs, and so you'll see my actual scanner. So every time I'm scanning a robot, meaning my radar runs across a robot, that event is generated, and I turn and do a 720. This is a very effective robot. Okay, but what it was doing before I made my beautiful change there was it would fire with certain power. So it would fire with a power of one. And let's go look at that fire method. So again, to do that, I go pull up my RoboCode API, which I can do by clicking on help and then RoboCode API in Java, or in not in Java in RoboCode, and that will pull up the RoboCode API. Once I'm there, I can go to the robot class, and inside the robot class, again, there's a bunch of different classes that the RoboCode package includes, and we're going to start looking at some of those other classes, but the main one that we extended from in our robot editor here at the top, we extended the robot class. So that's the one we're mainly interested in. So we click on the robot class, and there is a fire method that immediately fires a bullet. If we click on this method, it'll give us the signature public void fire double power. And this immediately fires a bullet. The bullet will travel in the direction the gun is pointing. The specified bullet power is the amount of energy that will be taken from your robot's energy. So the more power you want to spend on the bullet, the more energy is taken from your robot. And then it talks about the damage. The bullet will do four times the power if it hits another robot. If the power is greater than one, it will do an additional two times the power minus one. So if I fire with a power of three, then it will be three minus one is two, times two is four, and it will do four more damage. You will get back three times the power of the bullet if you hit the other robot. And so then it has the rules. The specified bullet power should be between the minimum bullet power and the maximum bullet power, which is between one and three, I believe, as a default. Note that the gun cannot fire if it's overheated, meaning gun heat returns a value greater than zero. Okay, and then it generates an event when the bullet hits a robot. So if I hit a robot, then it will generate a bullet hit event, a wall, bullet missed event, or another bullet hits bullet event. And so that's the fire method. So I pass in a double containing a power. And so if I go back to my Robo code editor and I say, back down to that method when we scan a robot, let's fire with a power of three instead of a power of one, which is what it was doing. And I don't need to put the 3.0 in there. If I put a three in there, that works just fine, but it is a double that's coming through. Okay, so that's that. Let's look at what other methods are in there. On hit by bullet, my current strategy is to go back 10. So just back up a little bit. Okay, well, that's a fine strategy. If we let's watch this kind of play out again, and now that we're learning what the code's doing, let's watch our robot. So now I fire with a power of 3 whenever I scan a robot. So it's doing that. It just really took out RAM fire pretty good. I'm getting lots of energy because I'm not missing too much, but now I'm starting to miss, and we'll watch my energy just kind of drop down as I'm missing by 3 at a time, a power of 3 at a time. If I get hit here, I should back up 10. I just got hit. I backed up 10. I got hit again, back up 10, back up 10. Well, that doesn't seem to be a real super strategy. It's not, I am winning, so maybe it is a great strategy. I don't know. But let's say we want to do something other than back up 10. Maybe we want to turn a certain amount and then back up, so we're not backing up in a straight line. Maybe we want to turn like 45 degrees and then back up. How about that? Well, if we want to do that, we need to go to our API. We'll pull up our API again, and I'll go back to the robot method and see, is there a turn the robot right method? Now, you'll want to look through all these to become familiar with the methods that are available. And so I'm going down the T's, and there is a turn right and turn left method. So I want to turn right 45 degrees. So I'm going to pass it in the number of degrees that I want to turn. So before I back up, I'm going to turn right 45 degrees. And then instead of backing up just 10, I'll back up 100. I'm going to try and get out of the path of these bullets for wherever I'm getting hit. And I'm not saying this is a great strategy. I'm just coming up with an example. Okay, so here we go. Restart this. Okay, let's see when I get shot. I should be getting shot here any minute. I just got shot, and there I did it. Now I'm backing into the wall repeatedly. This is ineffective because I won't stop backing into the wall. Every time I get shot, I back up more. So that wasn't great, but let's see if we can watch it in action here. Okay, I just got shot. I turned 45 degrees and then I backed up. I got shot again. I just turned 45 degrees and backed up. And then as soon as I get done doing that move, then it goes back to my default move, which is to go forward 100, turn the gun right 360 degrees, go backwards 100. And again, a very effective bot. I just won that round. Unless I back into a wall and then I'm in trouble like I just did here. Now I do nothing. Okay. Well, let's look at what other methods we have there. On hit wall, go back 20. Okay, maybe this is the problem. I'm going back 20 if I hit the wall. So maybe I want to put in another strategy here. If I hit the wall, then, you know, we could do an if statement, say which direction were we going and that type of stuff. For now, I'm just going to comment that out so I don't get stuck in the wall. So I compiled it. Let's go back and run it. Okay, so I'm going to get shot here and turn 45 degrees. Now I'm in the wall and I got destroyed. Makes it really hard to demonstrate when I'm get killed 30 seconds into the battle. Okay, so I'm getting hit and backing up and I didn't get shot there. Oh, I'm still going forward 300, aren't I? Corners will get me once fire's out. So corners just got me, and you can see me turn and then back up and then turn and then back up, but I'm not getting stuck in the wall because I'm no longer backing up when I hit a wall. Okay, so let's look at a few other things we can do. For example, what if my energy starts to get low? Now I'm firing with a power of 3 right now. What if I don't want to spend all my energy firing, especially if I'm not hitting anybody, right? And so maybe if I don't have enough energy, I don't want to fire with a power of 3. Well, I can do that by just programming like I would in Java. If, and then I need to get my energy level, then fire with a power of 3. So if my energy level is over a certain amount, now how do I get my energy? again, we'll jump to the API. And there was a method I remember from before that we said there was a method that was getEnergy. So this method, getEnergy, will return the robot's current energy. Okay? And so this is going to pass, we don't pass in anything, but we're going to get back a double that returns the robot's current energy. That's going to be what's going to be given to us. So if I can say, if getEnergy is less than 20, or sorry, we want to do greater than, if it's greater than 20, then fire with a power of 3, else fire with a power of 1. Now, it did end up putting an extra curly brace in there for me. It put it in when I put the opening brace. Now, if I try to compile this, it'll give me an error, just like I'm running any old Java program. So I compile this, and it'll say, sorry, there's an error. I have an error on line 47, syntax error on token brace, delete this token. And so I can go in and find that brace and delete it. And again, that works just like if I'm missing a semicolon on this line and I try to compile it. Error, insert semicolon to complete that block statement. And so this is just like writing other Java programs. Okay, so now I compile successfully. Now my strategy should be in place. Once I have an energy below 20, the problem is I just keep winning. I'm too good. And that has a lot to do with the selection of bots that I'm with. But you can notice how my bullets are big compared to what corners are. Corners are smaller. And again, they draw the pictures bigger based on... okay. I gotta quit winning. The bullets are drawn bigger based on their energy level, so you can kind of visually see what's going on with the bullets. Now, I would think that I would lose to Crazy because he's moving all over the place, and I'm firing with a power of 3 everywhere. But I guess if I hit him just enough, and if Crazy would start firing with me, now Crazy obviously has some sort of code in there. Okay, well, we can't see it. This is really bad for demonstration purposes. Let me throw more bots in there. Let's throw in target, and we'll do walls and start the battle, and then maybe we'll be able to lose energy quicker. And when I get below the energy of 20, these bullet sizes should change, and the bullet should fly faster because it's a smaller bullet. Once again, I'm just too good. Okay, I'm going to change my strategy here. Instead of being an energy less than 20, let's do an energy less than 90. Where there's a will, there's a way, right? That's what my mom used to always say. Okay, so save that, compile it. Let's try running it again. So as soon as my energy gets below 90, then I start shooting with small bullet, which is what I'm doing there. And now I just got killed by ram fire just when I... Oh, things never work the way you want them to. Okay, so again, once I get below that energy level, if I get below that energy level, okay, I'm just getting more and more energy. Okay, this is getting comical at this point. All right, well, we saw it in that demonstration there. I'm going to close this off before we hit the 15-minute mark, but... we'll go ahead and end there with this demonstration, and we'll continue on with looking at objects and how to use objects to our benefit. Spencer, shooting smaller bullets now.